What would you do as president to bring jobs and businesses back to the U.S.?
Well, if you compare the Republicans' talking points and the Democrats' talking points during election time, you'll find that they're pretty much identical. They're promising you that they're going to produce jobs, 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 jobs. That's all they want to talk about. In fact, it's not the government's job to produce jobs. The only jobs that government can produce are government jobs or subsidized jobs. And we've got plenty of those already, thank you very much. So what we need to do to restore prosperity in this country is to get the hand of government off the throat of the American people and off of their businesses. You do that by eliminating the federal income tax, going to a consumption-based tax system. That would be one of the biggest keys to restoring prosperity in this country. You get our monetary policy back under the control of we the people instead of in the hands of a quasi-governmental entity that was never part of the Constitution. You do that by getting government out of the business of controlling our private affairs. Get government off the range, get them out of the woods. Basically restore freedom in this country by returning to the enumerated powers of the Constitution, by shutting down every agency and program that is outside the bounds of the enumerated powers of our Constitution. You shrink government by returning to the Constitution. This is how you create prosperity in this country. You know, the left likes to talk about work and the honor of work and Labor Day and all of these things. But we're not supposed to be just labor. We are citizens. We are free citizens of this country. My ideal is not that everybody should have a paycheck. My ideal is that people should own the means of production, that they should own businesses. They should be in control of their own destiny once again. That is the vision that we should be pursuing. So the first thing we have to do is we have to get government under control. The way to get government under control is to begin to only elect those to public office who have demonstrated a clear understanding of their obligations under our Constitution, that understand that our framers of our Constitution did not set up unlimited government. They set up limited government of very specific powers. So that's how we get back on track. The American people have to get back in charge of their country once again.